Hello everyone, Dafty with you. Today's video we'll take a look at how to handle an in-flight engine fire. I already did a video about an engine fire while on the ground, while mainly during takeoff rolls and what we call a rejected takeoff or RTO. So you can check that out if you haven't seen that yet via top right or down below in the description. When an engine fire is detected, we follow an ECAM action, a read and do procedure. Part of the list involves extinguishing bottles located on each engine. The engines are equipped with two squibs to put out the fire on the affected engine. You need to manually discharge these squibs using the fire panel on the overhead. Once we secure the engine, we'll check to see in the system display on what's affected and inoperative, followed by the status page. This is a short demo view of the engine fire panel in the overhead of what would happen in the event the fire detection unit or FDU notices a fire happening. You'll see that the affected engine fire panel will illuminate, have an alarming chime, and issue an ECAM message. But the most important part about this panel is that once you flip the red guard and push the red rectangular push button, a signal is sent to the affected engine to cease working. In other words, you kill the engine. So it does seven things that has to do with killing the engine and one thing to protect the engine at the same time. The seven list goes as followed. It silences the alarm and chime that you just heard, which isn't modeled yet in the A32NX. Closes the low pressure fuel valve. Closes the hydraulic fire shutoff valve, which isn't modeled also. Closes the engine bleed valve, closes the pack flow valve, cuts out the FADEC which supplies the generator, and deactivates the IDG. Now the remaining list is just arming the squibs bottle as you saw in the engine fire panel. This is just to give you an insight what to expect and give you a general idea on how the fire protection panel works. So here we're just cruising along. I'll be anticipating fire engine number one momentarily, so I'm just going to wait for that to happen. So there's your alarm and chime. As you see in the ECAM, it says engine on fire, so master warning. Then we're going to do ECAM action. So the list goes as follows. So you're going to pull the thrust lever and the affected engine all the way back to idle so that the M1 decreases. So that's engine number one. Pull all the way back to idle. Next, you want to turn off the master switch to the off position, engine number one. Followed by an engine one fire push button, so you're going to look at the overhead, see which light's illuminating, which is on the left side, engine number one. You're going to remove the red guard and press the push button, and then wait for a 10 second discharge countdown. So once again, the reason why there's a 10 sec, because you want to make sure that the N1 decreases, so there's no nasal ventilation, and so that the agent one can discharge. So it can be effective when it gets discharged, as like right now. So 10 seconds expired. Now Agent 2 should say 30 seconds, although it says 10 seconds. But for sake purposes, we'll go with it. Now the reason why the ECAM disappeared, because the engine has been put out. So at this point, the engine is secured. Next, we're going to check the fuel imbalance. So we're going to check the fuel page. There's no leaks or anything, so that's good. So we're going to clear that page. And then we're going to set the TCAS mode to TA. And now we're going to check our system display. We're going to check the bleed page. You're going to notice that on engine number one, the bleed valves have been closed as we said earlier. So we're just going to open it because we're using anti-ice. Clear the bleed page. We're gonna clear the bleed page. Now you see electrical generator one's been shut off, so now generator two is supplying power to AC bus one and two. So I'm gonna turn on the APU so I can supply AC bus one. So that the galley shed message will disappear. Next, we're gonna clear the page in here. Unfortunately, this is a hydraulic page, which is not model, but the fly-by-wire team are working on that. So here at the status page, tells you what to do, what's recommended, and what not to do. And on the right side of the page is inoperative systems that we have right now. Wing anti-ice, cat 3 dual, engine 1 bleed, and such and all that. Basically all the lists I told you. So let's try engine number 2 this time. See how that goes. Okay, so here we're going to do engine fire number 2. We're just gonna wait for that to happen momentarily. So the list goes as as follow. Nothing changes besides the engine, so you're gonna push thrust lever number 2 back to all the way down to idle, all the way back to idle, and then turn off engine master number 2. That's it. So engine, so you have master warning, you have engine fire number 2, we're gonna follow the ECM actions. So pull the thrust all the way back to idle number 2, turn off the master switch on engine number 2, look up in the overhead panel, see which light's illuminating, and discharge. So wait for a 10 second agent 1 discharge, make sure that the N1 decreases down to 0, so once again that the agent, so the agents can become effective when it becomes discharged. So 10 seconds have been up, so we're going to discharge agent 1, and then we're going to wait 10 seconds hypothetically, although it should be 30, but it'll go out, the engine will be secured at this point. Now once the light goes off, the engine's secured. It's not the sound that tells you if something, if the engine's secured, it's the light above you. If you look at the overhead, the light's not illuminating, that means the engine's secured. So then we're going to set the thrust to MCT. Check for fuel imbalance. And then check, set the TA on the TCAS mode. So fuel page, nothing, there's no leaks or any abnormalities, so we're going to clear that, go to the next page. So on the bleed page, it's not modeled, but as you can see, this is the pack flow valve, and that's the engine bleed valves that are closed, so nothing supplying anything. Now the electric page is modeled properly, because that's the reason why it's modeled properly, because the team worked on it hardly, and I commend them for doing that. So everything's accurate. As I told you, generator 1 supply AC bus 1, AC bus 2. I'll turn on APU gen so they can supply power to AC bus 2 just for redundancy. There's no reason why I had to let one generator supply everything. So clear that. And on the hydraulics page, it's not modeled, but the folks at Flybars are working on it. This is what it looks like hypothetically. As you see in the yellow hydraulic system, that there's a low amber that tells you that, well, there's low pressure. Now the status page is exactly the same, the only thing missing is the yellow engine 2 pump and part of the inoperable system. As you can see here, I'll give you a slight comparison between it. But overall, it's basically the same, the only thing that's missing is the hydraulics list only, so as you can see right here. So ECM action is complete, so engine secured, everything's good. Now the most appropriate thing to do is find an airport landing, that's all. So this is basically how you would handle an in-flight engine fire. If you're using VATSIM or Pilot Edge, I don't utilize those. So you guys give that a go. Hopefully you found this very informative and helpful. If you guys like what you see, then consider subscribing so you don't miss anything related to aviation, Microsoft Flight Simulator. So that'll be it. Thanks for watching. I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. Take care.